effects, there exist a number of analytical methods. But sometimes, though we know effects completely, it is not always easier, or rather not always possible, to evaluate definite integral of effects by those analytical methods. Also, there may be case where a table of values is known, but in that case, the known analytical methods fail to find a definite integral. What we do in that case? In that case, we use numerical integration to evaluate a definite integral. The Newton-Cotes formula are the most common numerical integration schemes. They are based on the strategy of replacing, say, a complicated function or tabulated data with an approximating function. That is, we are replacing a complicated function by an approximating function that is easy to integrate. Here, originally I is this, fx is the given function. Now we are approximating fx by, say, fnx. So we get not the exact value of the integration, we get approximate value of the integration by replacing fx by fnx. And what is fnx? Fnx is a polynomial of the form this. Where n is the order of polynomial. Consider this graph. Fx, x. Let the given function be represented in this way. This. Now what we do? First let we take 2 points here. 2 points. Draw a straight line joining this point. What integration means? Integration means evaluating the function. Integrating a function means just evaluating the area under the function. Here, instead of evaluating the area under this given curve, we are approximating this function fx by a straight line, that is first order polynomial. Hence, instead of evaluating the area under the given curve, we are just evaluating the area under the straight line that is approximating the given curve. Consider another case. Let this is the given curve. Consider 3 points. Now in this case, a parabola is used as an approximation. So here we are evaluating the area under this parabola. Now Newton-Cotes formulas are available either in closed form or in open form. What is closed form? Closed form means, consider this graph. This is a point, this is the end point, and this is other points. So in closed form of Newton-Cotes formula, the data points at the beginning and the end of the limits of integration are known. See, at the beginning and at the end of integration are known. But in case of open form, these are data points. In case of open form, the limits of the integration extends beyond the range of data. These are not generally used for definite integration. Next, I will discuss the trapezoidal rule of integration, of definite integration. The trapezoidal rule is the first of the Newton-Cotes formula where the polynomial is of first order. That is, where the polynomial is first order, where n is equal to 1, that means. So here we can write, which is approximated as by a first order polynomial. This, now a straight first order polynomial means it's a straight line. Now a straight line can be represented as if A B minus A X minus A. Now the area under this straight line is an estimate of the integral of fx between limits a and b. It will be clear if we define it graphically. Let this is the case fx and this is x. Now consider this graph, this function. Let it be fa and let it be fb. Now the trapezoidal rule is equivalent to approximating area of the trapezoid under the straight line connecting fa and fb. So what trapezoidal rule does, it just approximate the integration by the trapezoid joining a, b, c and d, this portion. Hence the area under the straight line is an estimate of the integral of fx between limits a and b. So I can be written as, that is the total integral value, that can be written as a to b fa plus fb minus fa divided by b minus a x minus a dx. That is, we are integrating this within limits a and b. The result of this integration is, I'm not going into detail, I'm just writing the formula. This is the trapezoidal rule. That is, here again I am considering it graphically. Here what we are considering, we are considering I, that is getting approximated by the area of trapezoidal ABCD, which is equal to width of the trapezoid into average height. Now what is the width? That is b minus a, and average height is average of the function values at the end points, that is fa plus fb divided by 2. This is the trapezoidal rule. Now here we are approximating the area under a curve by a straight line, hence there must be some error. An estimate of the local truncation error of a single application of the trapezoidal rule can be written as minus 1 by 12 f double dash xi b minus a whole cube. I am not going in detail of how we have got this expression, just remember it, where xi lies between a and b. Now look at the expression of the error term. The expression for ET shows that the degree of precision of the formula is 1. Clearly, which indicates that if the function being integrated is linear, the trapezoidal rule will be exact. And for any function with second and higher order derivatives, some error can occur. So here one important point is the degree of precision in case of trapezoidal rule one. And the trapezoidal rule gives exact value when the function being integrated is linear. Next is trapezoidal rule. Composite trapezoidal rule. Now, one way to improve the accuracy of trapezoidal rule is to divide the integration interval from A to B into a number of segments and apply the basic trapezoidal rule method in each of these segment. So, if we replace the trapezoidal rule by its composite counterpart, we get an improved accuracy. That is, the error gets reduced. So, graphically, what is composite trapezoidal rule? Here, consider this. This is fx, this is x, and consider the function to be integrated. This. Now, here we are considering number of intervals between the limits a and b. That is, one is x0, corresponding ordinate is fx0. Yes, it is x1. Here it is x2, here it is fx2. Similarly, proceeding this way, we get, so this is the xn minus 2, so it is fxn minus 2. Let it be xn minus 1, so it will be fxn minus 1. Similarly, it will be xn. So it is fxn. Now, the areas of individual segments, if this is an individual segment, this is another segment like this, this is, these all are individual segments. Now, the areas of individual segments are added to yield the final result. And the resulting equation is called the composite formula. So in the figure, there are how many equally spaced base points? N plus 1, x0 to x1. There are n plus 1 based points which are equally spaced. That is, the difference between x0 and the distance between x0 and x1, x1, x2, like this, is all equal. So there exist n segments of equal width, and we denote the width as h. So we can write h as equal to b minus a by n. So we can write the total integral I as dx x1 to x2 fx dx. Similarly, joining others, xn minus 1 xn fx dx. Now, substituting the trapezoidal rule for each interval, what we get? Here it is h, as we have seen before. We can write it in this way. Now, apply trapezoidal rule in the second segment, that is h into f x1 plus f x2 divided by 2. Similarly, we get the last term as h into f x n minus 1 plus f x n divided by 2. Simplifying, we can write h by 2 f x 1 like this up to f x n minus 1 and the last ordinate f x n. So after we can write it as also 0, 2 times I is equal to 1 to n minus 1 f x I plus f x n. This is the composite trapezoidal rule. Now, error is calculated in composite trapezoidal rule by summing the individual errors for each segment, and we get error as minus n h cube divided by 12 f double dash xi, that is second order derivative of fx, which can be written as, that is replacing h by b minus a by n, we can write it as also b minus a whole cube divided by 12 n square f double dash xi, where xi lies between a and b. Note that here error is inversely proportional to the square of n. So what does it mean? It means if the number of segments is doubled, that is if n is doubled, the truncation error, that is e, will be quartered. But in case if n is very large, one has to calculate a large number of ordinates, which in other case increases the amount of computations. And also a large value of n might produce a large amount of round off error also. So now I will discuss some great problems regarding trapezoidal rule. Consider this problem. The trapezoidal rule for integration gives exact result when the integrand is a polynomial of degree what? In that case, consider the error term for say composite trapezoidal rule, that is whole cube 12 n square f double dash xi. Now if fx is a polynomial of say degree less than equal to 1, in that case f double dash x will be what? Xi will be what? 0. So the error term becomes 0. So the trapezoidal rule gives exact result for a polynomial of degree less than equal to 1. So the answer should be, it may be 0 or it may be 1. So answer should be C. Consider this problem. If the trapezoidal method is used to evaluate the integral this, then the value obtained is always greater than 1/3 or always greater less than 1/3 or equal to 1/3 or maybe or greater than, greater or lesser than 1/3. Now in this case you can proceed by using the iterative formula for trapezoidal rule, but it will take more time. Now we can solve it in other way. We know fx is equal to x squared, the graph is like this. This is the graph. Now if we simply integrate this equation, this function, what we get? This is x cube by 3, 1 to 0, that is 1 by 3. The actual value of the integration is 1/3. Here we are considering only this portion, 0 to 1. Only this portion of the graph we are considering. Okay, this is not considered. So the actual value is 1/3. Now if we use trapezoidal rule, what we do? We approximate the function by a straight line joining this. So this approximated area will be the area under this straight line. So clearly from this diagram we are getting it as a greater than 1/3. So the actual region is this. This is the region we are getting more because of use of trapezoidal rule. So the answer will be A. So if you draw that diagram again, that it has become a bit clumsy. Here we are considering this. So we have to, this area is 1/3. But in case of trapezoidal rule, we are approximating by this and we are getting this portion extra. So the answer is greater than 1/3. Consider this problem. A calculator has accuracy up to 8 digits after decimal place. The value of this integration 0 to 2 pi sin x dx, when evaluated using the calculator by trapezoidal method with 8 equal sub intervals to 5 significant digit is what? Now in this case I will show you how to use the iterative formula of trapezoidal rule. Here h is b minus a by n, b is 2 pi, a is 0 and n is 8. So h is 2 pi divided by 8. Now draw a table where column xi represents the value of xi, first x0 which is 0, x1 is x0 plus h which is 2 pi divided by, as the points are equally spaced, x2 is x1 plus h that is 4 pi divided by 8, similarly x3 is 6 pi by 8, x4 is 8 pi by 8. Since there are 8 intervals, how many points will be there? N plus 1, that is 8 plus 1, that means 9 points will be there. Now what is x5? That is equal to 10 pi divided by 8. X6 is 12 pi by 8. Similarly, x7 is 14 pi by 8 and x8 is 2 pi. Now evaluate the function value at the corresponding x values, fxi. Use the calculator and get the value as 0. This is 0.707107. This is 1. This is 0.707107. We get it as 0. And lastly we get 0. Now apply the composite trapezoidal rule. What is the value of the integration? Which is equal to, now I is equal to h divided by 2, that is pi by 8, that is fx0 first 0 plus fx8, that is also 0, plus 2 times summation of all these values. See, clearly summation of all these values is 0. So our answer is 0, that is A. Next I will discuss Simpson's one-third rule, that is Simpson's rule. It is a 3-point or 2-interval Newton quotes closed formula. That is where n is equal to 2. That is, it is a 3-point or 2-interval Newton-Cotes closed formula in which a second-order interpolating polynomial is substituted as approximation. So in this case, we can write, which is approximated by, where f2x is a polynomial of degree 2. So what is graphical representation of Simpson's one-third rule? In this case, consider this. Consider this graph. So in Simpson's rule, instead of 2 points, 3 points are considered. Let one point is this, second point is this, and third point is this, and draw a parabola through this point. So Simpson's one-third rule consists of taking the area under a parabola connecting 3 points on the curve. This point and this point. So in this case, I will just write down the integration, iterative formula of integration. That is I is equal to, that is Simpson's, h divided by 3, fx0 plus, h is as before, fx1, plus fx2. Here x0 is equal to A and x2 is equal to B. And h is B minus A by 2. So we can write the formula as B minus A by 6 FA plus 4 into FA plus B divided by 2 plus FB. This is the Simpson's one-third rule. It can be shown that a single segment application of Simpson's one-third rule has a truncation error of this. Just remember the formula: h to the power minus h to the power 5 divided by 90 f to the 4 xi, where xi is a point between A and B. This is clearly order of h to the power 5. You have to remember this. Since h is equal to b minus a by 2, we can write this error term as equal to minus b minus a to the power 5 divided by 2880 into this. Simpson's one-third rule is more accurate than the trapezoidal rule. Here, error is proportional to the fourth derivative of the function. Suppose fx is a polynomial of degree less than or equal to 3. Then in that case, the fourth derivative at the point xi will be 0. Which implies Simpson's one-third rule gives us exact value for a polynomial of degree less than or equal to 3. Hence, in this case, degree of precision is 3. Now what is composite version of Simpson's one-third rule? Just as with the trapezoidal rule, Simpson's rule can be improved by dividing the integration interval into a number of segments of equal width. Then h becomes equal to this. The total integral can then be represented as here it is x2, because 3 points are taken. Similarly, x2 to x4 fx dx, like this, n minus 2 to xn fx dx. Now substituting Simpson's basic one-third rule for the individual integrals, we get this as equal to, hence we are getting the value of I as this. Finally we get h by 3 fx0 plus first and last term as it is plus 4 times fx1 fx3 like this fxn minus 1 plus 2 times fx2 plus fx4 like this fxn minus 2, which we can write as h by 3 sum of first and last ordinates plus 4 times sum of all odd ordinates plus 2 times sum of all even ordinates. This is the Simpson's composite one-third rule. Now one thing to note, that an even number of segments must be utilized to implement the method. So here the number of segments must be even. Also in this case, an error estimate for the composite Simpson's one-third rule is obtained by summing the individual errors for the segments, and this is obtained as minus n h to the power 5 divided by 180 fourth derivative of fx at xi, where a xi less than b. A and xi lies between a and b, and which can also be written as minus b minus a to the power 5. That is, replacing h by b minus a by n, we get it as 180 n to the power 4 f 4 xi. Now, there are some limitations of Simpson's one third rule. First limitation is, it is limited to cases where the values are equispaced. And the second one is, it is limited to situation where there are even number of segments and odd number of points. Consider this great problem. Simpson's rule for integration gives exact result when function fx is a polynomial of degree 1, 2, 3 and 4. See, we have seen that Simpson's rule of integration gives exact result when polynomial is degree of polynomial is less than or equal to 3. So in that case, a, b, c, all three can be the answer. Consider the next problem. Use Simpson's one-third rule to approximate the given integration 0 to 2 e to the power x squared dx using n is equal to 6. Here, fx is equal to e to the power x squared. A is equal to 0 and b is equal to 2. Then what is the value of h? That is equal to b minus a by n. N is given as 6, and which is equal to 1/3. Next, write down the values of xi and their corresponding values of yi. So x0 is 0, x1 is 1/3, what is x2? X1 plus h, that is 2/3. Similarly, x3 is x2 plus h, that is 1. X4 is 4/3, X5 is 5/3, and X6 is 2. And the corresponding values of Y0 is, Yi is, it is 1, that is Y0. Here it is 1.12, which is equal to Y1. 1.56, that is Y2. 2.72, that is equal to y3. 5.92, that is equal to y4. 16.08, that is equal to y5. And last, it is 54.60, which is equal to y6. Now, the value, the required answer will be is equal to 8 by 3, that is 1 by 9 within bracket, sum of first and last ordinates, that is y0 plus y6, y0 plus y6, next plus 4 into sum of all odd ordinates, that is y1, y3 and y5. That means 4 into y1 plus y3 plus y5, and next addition 2 into sum of all even ordinates, that is y2 and y4, that is 2 into y2 plus y4. Now putting the values of yi's, we get the required approximation.